Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining why BGP requires routing to already be established within an autonomous system in order for it to function. Now, one question that often arises when examining the operation of BGP is why do we need an IGP or static routing within an AS to allow BGP to operate? Isn't BGP a routing protocol itself? Why doesn't it take care of routing within the AS? Why do we need to deploy another routing protocol to make BGP work? Well, in order to answer this question, let's first describe in detail this prerequisite as defined by the BGP protocol itself, and then we'll examine why this is the case. Now, when you deploy BGP, you configure internal BGP, or IBGP peerings, between BGP routers in the same AS, and you configure EBGP peerings between BGP routers in different ASs. Looking at this diagram, we can see that an IBGP peering will be established between R1 and R3, and an EBGP peering will be established between R1 and R2. Now, the prerequisite that we're talking about here, when fully stated, is this. Routing must be established within a particular AS using an interior gateway protocol, or IGP, such as EIGRP or OSPF, or even static routing, such that all routers within that AS can reach each other. So within our AS100, for example, we need to have configured routing so that all these routers can communicate with each other successfully. Now, the main reason for this requirement is because IBGP, to function correctly, requires a full mesh peering. That means that each IBGP router within AS100 must create a BGP peering with every other IBGP router in that AS. If routers are not reachable using some kind of IGP or static routing, then this cannot happen. So that's the prerequisite. But why? BGP is a routing protocol itself. It's kind of counterintuitive to think that you need another routing protocol to allow this routing protocol to work. The key here is to understand what routing the IGP is responsible for and what routing BGP is responsible for. Each one is responsible for something different. From the point of view of an AS, BGP is responsible for learning about routes that are external to that AS. EBGP is responsible for advertising that information from AS to AS, while IBGP is responsible for propagating those external routes within an AS. So to look at a practical example, in our diagram here, R1 will learn via its EBGP peering with R2 about the 30.30.30.0/24 network. R1 will then relay that information to all other IBGP routers within AS100. Remember, R1 has IBGP peerings with all internal BGP routers, so all routers within AS100 will learn about the 30.30.30.0/24 network. So BGP then is responsible for advertising external networks to a particular AS. EBGP advertises those networks between ASs, and the BGP router on the edge of the AS, which in our case is R1, learns about those routes and then relays them to the routers internal to that AS using IBGP. So the key thing to note here is that BGP, including both EBGP and IBGP, will advertise information about routes external to the local AS. BGP is not responsible for advertising networks internal to the local AS within the AS. That task falls to the IGP or static routing. Now, what about the 20.20.20.0/24 network? Won't IBGP within AS100 share that among the IBGP routers? Well, yes, but only for the purpose of sending it out to neighboring ASs, not for the purpose of internal routing. Now, it is this hierarchical approach that BGP uses, and in the vast majority of cases, IGPs are used internal to an AS, and BGP is used for external networks. It is possible, however, to employ BGP to advertise networks within an AS. However, this is not typically done, and it's not considered best practice because BGP is not designed for this. It's much slower to converge than IGPs, and it may cause unexpected results. This should only be done under specific circumstances, and it should be done with great care. So in summary, IGPs or static routing must be established within an AS before BGP can be configured. IBGP requires a full mesh of IBGP peerings to operate. BGP's role, both internal and external BGP, is to inform the BGP routers within an AS about networks that are external to the local AS. And although BGP can be configured to advertise routes locally within an AS, this is not typically best practice, as BGP has not been designed for this purpose. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click the thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates of newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at telecomTech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.